Did you have the party house? Did you have the house? Maybe your aunt was like, all right, here's the deal. If you're going to be smoking your marijuana, if you're going to be drinking your Goldschlager, you're doing it here. No one leaves, and you stay in the night. Now pour mommy a shot. I'm getting loosey-goosey. I want to get crazy. I want to take off my underpants. I want to take off my underwear. A lot of good-looking boys in here.
410-338-1098.
Josh, I'm not even going to ask you. Yeah. Honor roll student. Honor roll student. There's no way that you were sneaking over a 40 of St. Ives or a bottle of MD 2020.
No, I was a pretty boring kid.
You were a studious kid, a kid whose eyes were on the future, not the immediate. Joe, who did you smoke meth with at 12?
I have this.
Whose house did you freebase
give
at?
Give us the list.
I had the same experience as Josh.
First and last names.
Honor school. Okay.
Eagle Scout Stamboni over here. Yeah, you're making fires in the backyard and making your own maps like a junior topographer. No, you definitely was a guy.
Oh, dude, there was
who
so
had
many
the house
guys.
If it wasn't your it house.
It was a whole network. This person's.
Did you have the weed house, the booze house?
It was just kind of an amalgamation of
house
of all. No, one of my friends that grew up, like he lived right behind me. His house was behind mine.
Yeah.
His mom was a nurse, and she worked at night. And his dad
sounds like a slut.
Yeah.
What?
Yeah. His dad, a plumber, he would go work across seas doing plumbing.
Wait,
for like months at a time.
He would go and do foreign plumbing.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. And he made a bunch of money. I don't know. Yeah.
Was he in a war zone or working for some
no,
evil dictator?
It was on an island in the Caribbean.
There's not a lot of good clogs here. There's a fatberg.
Yeah.
I hear there's a lot of like immigrant Sicilians flushing lasagna down the toilet in New York. You can't go and head up there to Big Apple. So he's gone.
He's gone. So he'd be gone for like 6 months at a time. His mom would be working nights and she like altered on and off every other week. Anytime she was working nights and his dad was out of town, that was at the party house. And like,
did she know? She had to have known
because she was friends with all the neighbors. And I'm not talking like eight kids would come over. I'm talking about like rager, like 150 kids show up.
Jesus.
Cars
in the lawn.
Yeah. Kids would park up at the end of the street and there would just be a line of cars.
I mean, the cops are getting called, right? Stuff's getting damaged. Pets go missing.
I don't think cops ever got called. Things got damaged, but this kid was responsible enough. Somehow, every time after the party, kids would get out. He would clean everything up, and the house would be good to go by 8 a.m.
Mom wouldn't care. Did you know a place? Like, I had a couple of places. I'm not going to say the kid's name. Let's just call him Jason Willis. And his dad would let us drink at his place, and his dad would sit in there and drink with us.
Yeah.
And he would just hold court. Now, we're probably like 16, 17. We're too young to drink, but we're not like toddlers. He's not taking photos of us. All right, now spread your butt cheeks. Like, he would just sit in there and just tell us stories of his time in the Army. And he was cool, but at the same time, it was exceptionally eagle. It wasn't like 100 kids, but it might have been like 15, 16. We'd sit around and, you know, he had a big ass two-car garage, folding chairs,
yep,
a couple of toolboxes we'd sit up on, and he was the party house. 410-338-1098. What was the party house in the neighborhood? The weed house, the booze house, the sex house?
Oh.
Mm-hmm. 410-338-1098, at JSS98Rock on Twitter. Did you have the party house?
No.
Did you have a party house in the neighborhood?
No. We just drank in the woods, man. Mostly. There, on the off chance that there was like a house party, there was one girl, Karen Mead, where her parents were out of town, and she threw a house party. It wasn't like the regular drinking house, but like she threw a house party, and I was like, how are you doing this? Like, there are 100 people in every room.
That's what Joe was saying.
It was like, what are you doing?
He said the place looked like a high school hallway in between class periods. Everyone in there was so jammed up. Joe, before we get to Beth, Country, others, 410-338-1098, was there damage done to that place when they left?
Is this a house party or was this the party house?
This was a house party at the party house.
The party house. 100 plus people packed into this Parkville Palace.
Yeah, this was Perry Hall.
Ooh.
What's the classic mistake of after having a house party, though?
Too clean.
That's right.
Yeah, you gotta have.
You're 100% right.
Gotta make it look lived in.
It's too clean. When your parents come walking back in the house and they smell cleaning products and everything is spotless and the place is too clean, they go, yeah. "Wait a minute, we didn't leave the house this clean.
Wait,
what the hell went on in here?"
Mudge tells the story of her having a house party, and they had a rager, and they do that, but the parents didn't pick up on it. They were kind of expected to clean while they were away. They're sitting down at dinner, and they did the damn thing. I mean, they tried to cover up a crime scene.
Yes.
Scrubbing skull out of carpet. They're sitting down there. They're having dinner. She and her 3,000 siblings. And her sister is elbowing her under the table.
Uh-oh.
And they look over mom's shoulder. And at the bottom of a curtain, there is a twisted teacup on the floor.
Yeah.
That they notice that they missed the cap. And it was just them sweating through their halter tops, trying to get over there to get that cap. They did. They were never caught. 410-338-1098. Beth, you had the spot?
Well, it wasn't exactly a party house. It was just me and my friend. We were only 13, but we had somebody that we called a packy runner, and he was of age, so he would go to the liquor store and buy us what we wanted. And our drink of choice was Yukon Jack.
Ooh.
Now, this runner, he's of age. Obviously, he's 21 years older. Did he buy the booze and leave, or would he stay and hang out with you?
He would buy it and leave.
Thank God.
Nice.
Okay. Whew. For a second, I thought the story was going to take a dark turn.
Her dad was always on business trips. Her mother was an alcoholic, so she was always passed out.
No kidding.
And didn't know what we were doing.
Oof. So how did everyone end up? Where are you at now in life?
I am extremely happy as a school bus driver in Harford County, and I work in the high school cafeteria.
The lunch lady. Have some more sloppy joe.
Navy beans, navy beans, navy beans. Yeah, I didn't want it to start out, end up like the, was it The Kids Aren't All Right by The Offspring? Thank you for the call, love. Let's go to Joanna. Where's Joanna at? Line 3. Joanna, Hello. Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
So, we're currently dealing with the house that all of my teenage boys want to come to do like TikTok videos and to chill out. I hope that they're not doing drugs and alcohol in our basement, but they're doing stupid enough stuff that I wouldn't be surprised. I caught them like 2 weekends ago. Like, there were 6 15-year-old boys. They were running around upstairs. So my husband went up there to see what they were doing, and they were all in their underwear, taking cold showers, and then jumping on our roof, running up and down on our roof when it was like 20 degrees outside.
What the?
That's just boy stuff.
So far, it just sounds like boy stuff, but the tone of your voice when you say, I hope they're not drinking, smoking, leads me to believe you might be compartmentalizing the realities of the situation.
What do you think the odds of that are? How old are they? 15?
15 and 16.
It might happen in the next year or two. You gotta have conversations. You communicate. You gotta have that tough talk. But do you think it's already happening?
I don't think he is, but I'm some of his friends.
Do his friends show up with, like, giant backpacks?
Yes, they have backpacks.
Yeah, then they have booze.
The backpacks, yeah.
I was just at my buddy's house the other day, and his son is a senior in high school, and he's going on to college next year, and his two of his buddies showed up, and they went straight to the basement. His one buddy had the biggest backpack on I've ever seen. And I go, there's a 12-pack in there. I'm not a moron.
There's a liter of vodka.
There's 100%. Like, I knew exactly what it was, and he kind of knew, too. They were getting picked up, and they were going out to the Towson bars, but they were definitely doing some drinking that night. You got to just stay on top of it. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Are they good kids? Are they good kids?
They are good kids.
Okay.
I mean, yeah, but I mean, I'll wake up, and there'll be like a Walmart shopping cart in our front lawn. So I know that they're doing bad stuff at night.
Okay, I'll be honest. These
hilarious.
Kids sound like a damn blast.
Yeah, just make sure they're not getting too wild.
Elba, what's going on?
Hi,
just shopping.
It's me, Elba.
Hi, Elba.
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 Good morning. Shout out to my husband, Izzy, if he's listening. I love you.
Elba, wow. It says that you were bitching about being on hold for too long.
Yes, sir.
Got it.
No.
Just kidding. You're still here, you pain in the ass. So what was going on with the party house, you human fruit fly?
So Ellerslie Court in Abingdon. Shout out to all my neighbors. Ugh. Our house was the party house. We had Cubanos. We had Mama Juana. We had, I mean, everybody come in with cases of beer, liquor. My husband and his friends would drop off other husbands in front of the house, ring the bell, and run.
Okay, there's blood leaking from my ear. Mm-hmm. Did you just say one word?
Did she call it Mami Juana?
Mami Juana? That might be how I say it.
And I heard Cubanos. Listen, marijuana and Cubanos sounds like a fun-ass time.
That actually sounds not just delicious, but like a really damn good. Did you say Mami Juana?
Mama Juana is fermented liquor. It's Bacardi. Yeah, it's like, you know, from the South, the way they make the liquor in the South. How do you call it?
Moonshine.
Shine.
It's like moonshine, but it's Puerto Rican style and Dominican style. Yeah.
Okay. We got to get some Mami Juana.
Dude, I want to party with you.
So it gets unnaturally angry over tiny things. Thank you, Alba. Let's go to Country. Country, what's up, pal?
Morning, fellas.
Morning,
hey,
pal.
Buddy.
My buddy had one down Miller Island, and I used to ride my dirt bike from Dundalk down Miller Island.
Wait, you get on your dirt bike and drive and ride to where?
Miller Island.
Oh yeah, okay.
And we always had fun and got drunk as hell.
What's in your throat right now? What is that? Can you clear that out?
Have an octopus in there.
There you go. Get a little more. Get a little more. You got to clear a little more.
I didn't have enough natural light yet this morning.
Okay.
Got to
clear it out with the natural lights.
Fly with the angel wings.
Yeah, it's like Drano.
We draw a type.